Hi guys, welcome back to Absolute Brushes. If you're new here, I'm Pranjali. Thank you so much for tuning in. Today I'm creating this super glam, super gorgeous holiday makeup look. So if you want to know how I got this look, please keep on watching. So to prep my skin, I'm first using this hydrating primer by Makeup Forever on the areas where my skin flakes the most. For the rest of my face, I'll be using the Milani Prime Perfection Hydrating Primer because the rest of my face is pretty normal. And to fill in the pores of my forehead and my nosy, I'll be using the BB Skin Insta Pore Eraser Primer. And for the pores under my eyes, I'm using the Professional Primer by Benefit Cosmetics because I have huge pores in this area. To color correct, I'm using this Salmon Shade Corrector from Miss Clair. As you can see, I have some discoloration around my mouth. So what this Salmon Shade Corrector will do is that it will neutralize it, bringing it back to my skin shade so that it doesn't look ashy under my foundation. For the foundation, I'm going for the PAC HD Liquid Foundation in the shade 3.9, and to blend it, I'm using a damp beauty blender. And when I use a corrector underneath my foundation, I tend to use a beauty blender as opposed to a brush because this tends to move the corrector underneath the foundation. Because I'm breaking out a little under my lip area, I'm concealing it using a concealer that is the exact shade of my skin tone, which is the PAC Take Cover Concealer in the shade Stark Nude. And I'm using an angled flat top kabuki brush to blend it because I want more coverage out of this concealer. And to highlight under my eyes, my forehead, my chin and my nosy, I'm using the PAC Take Cover Concealer in the shade Stark Nude and Beach Sand. And I'm using my angled flat top kabuki brush from Cuffs and Lashes to blend it into my skin. And to clean up underneath my cheekbones, I'm using the LA Girl Pro Conceal in the shade Creamy Beige. And to blend it, I'm using my angled flat top kabuki brush from Cuffs and Lashes. To bring back that dimension and structure to my face, I'll be contouring my face using the LA Girl Pro Conceal in the shade Beautiful Bronze. Now this is 3 to 4 shades darker than my skin tone, so it will help in creating those shadows that got concealed with the foundation and the concealer. I'm using this in the usual places like my cheekbone, circumference of my face, my jawline and my nosy. And to blend it, I'm using my angled flat top kabuki brush from Cuffs and Lashes. To bring back that warmth to my skin, I'll be using a bronzer. Now this will go right above my contour, and I'm using the Hoola Bronzer by Benefit Cosmetics, and to blend it into my skin I'm using an angled brush. For blush, I'm picking up this rosy pink shade from the Ofra Cosmetics Signature Palette, and I'm using an angle brush to apply it, and to blend it I'm using my powder brush. To set my concealer, I'll be using a loose powder. This one's new Master Fix Setting Loose Powder by Maybelline. But because I have a very dry skin type, I'm only using this in the places where my concealer creases the most. And to highlight the high points of my face, I'll be using a highlighter. This one's Sun Dipped Glow Kit Palette by Anastasia Beverly Hills. And I'm using the shade Summer with my fan brush. And to set and seal everything in place and to lock that base makeup in, I'll be using a setting spray. This one's by Pack Prep and Prime. To clean up underneath my brows, I'll be using the Pack Takeover Concealer in the shade Beach Sand. And to set it in place, I'm using the Master Fix Setting Loose Powder by Maybelline. And for my brows, I'm just filling in the sparse areas with the brown eyeshadow from Makeup Revolution Ultra Eyeshadow Palette, and I'm using a spoolie to spread the color across so that it looks more natural. And to get those dramatic straight edges, I'll be using a sticky tape. To warm up my crease area, I'm dipping into this very warm salmon shade Burnt Orange from the Modern Renaissance Palette by ABH Cosmetics with my larger blending brush by Real Techniques. To further intensify my crease, I'm using the same Burnt Orange shade and I'm packing it in my crease area using my pack brush in the style 126, and to blend it, I'm using my smaller blending brush by ABH Cosmetics. To deepen my outer corners and my crease area a little bit more, I'm picking up the shade Red Ochre from Modern Renaissance Palette by ABH Cosmetics, and I'm depositing it with my pack brush in the style 126. To blend it, I'm using my smaller blending brush by ABH Cosmetics. Taking the shade Love Letter by Modern Renaissance Palette by ABH Cosmetics with my pack brush in the style 126, I'll be applying it in the middle of my lid, mixing it with the red ochre shade a little bit, and I'm blending it using my smaller blending brush by ABH Cosmetics. To cut the crease, I'm using the shade Beach Sand from Pack Takeover Concealer, and I'm only taking it till the middle of my lid using my small short shader brush. Next, I'm decorating my crease with this very pretty shimmery silver shade Vermeer from Modern Renaissance Palette by ABH Cosmetics using my flat brush, again by ABH Cosmetics, and I'm kneading its edges using my flat short shader brush. To brighten my inner corners and my brow bone, I'm using the shade Vermeer with my smaller pencil brush by Real Techniques. Next, I'm smoking out my lower lash line with the shade Red Ochre with my pack brush in the style 126. To line my top lash line, I'm using the Lakmé Insta Liner. And for my waterline, I'm using the Magnet Eye Kajal by Faces Canada. And for lipstick, I'm using the shade Read My Lips from Faces Canada. For falsies, I'm using the Sloshy Lashes in the style Breezer, but before that I had already curled my lashes and I've coated them with some mascara. The mascara that I used was Total Temptation by Maybelline, but unfortunately it didn't get recorded, so I'm just mentioning it for your convenience. And here is the finished look. I've paired it up with some bold statement earrings and this off-shoulder white top. I love how dramatic and classy this look turned out. Of course, you can pair it with any attire you like. So if you like this video, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up. And if you're new here, please take a moment to subscribe. I post several videos a week. I've left all the product information along with my socials in the description box down below in case you want to follow me there. I love you guys so much and I'll see you in my next video. Bye guys.